In this lecture, we will learn a new method which is called work energy method, by which we can solve different kinetics problem. Already we have learned one method which was D'Alembert's principle, by using which we also have solved a problem. Now in this lecture we will see the next method, which is work energy method. So before learning the method, let us see what is work energy. The work energy means when you apply a force on a body, and due to the application of this force, if the body displaces and come to a new position, then due to this displacement, the body will store some form of energy, which is called work energy, and which is calculated by taking the product of force vector with the displacement. And as the work energy is a scalar quantity, so we should follow the dot product. So finally, we will get Fds cos theta, which can be interpreted this way: the product of component of force along the direction of displacement with the displacement. So F cos theta is the component of force along the displacement, which is shown here. If I split the F, I will get two components. One will be acting along the ds, which is causing the displacement. So due to this component, the work will be storing in the body, which is the product of the component with the ds. And the perpendicular component is not causing any displacement, so it will not do any work. In international standard, means SI, the unit of the work is product of Newton meter, as it is product of the two vector, force and the displacement, which is called 1 joule. 1 Newton meter is expressed as 1 joule. Now see, if we want to calculate the work done under a force which is varying with the displacement, means it is not constant with respect to the displacement, it is the magnitude of the force is also changing with the corresponding displacement of the particle. So in this case, if you want to calculate the work done, then you have to measure the area under this curve in between the required displacement portion. Suppose I want to know the work done by the work done stored in the body when it displaces from its initial position to a new position S. So to calculate this area, we need to take a elementary strip. So here the element, here the thickness of the elementary strip has been considered as ds, as it is along the s. And if you neglect this much variation, means this small variation, we can consider that the total force is remaining constant for this zone, which is considered as capital F. So the area of this small element, as it's a rectangular strip, will be Fds. So the work done for this small zone can be represented as dw. Now by integrating this, we can get the total work done. So we have to put the limit by putting the initial displacement to the final displacement. Here F is a function of ds. So when we will get the relation between F ds, we can put it here. Then we can integrate the equation to know the total work done stored in the body. Now energy. Energy is defined as the capacity to do work. As an example, heat energy, chemical energy, mechanical energy, electrical energy. But as we are discussing with the engineering mechanics, basically solid mechanics, so our interest is only with the mechanical energy. The mechanical energy can be classified into two parts: kinetic energy and potential energy. Kinetic energy means this shows the capacity to do work due to the motion of the body. When a body moves with certain velocity, it possesses some energy. By utilizing it, it can do some work. That is called kinetic energy. Similarly, potential energy means the energy stored in a body due to its position. If I bring a brick or a mass to a certain height, suppose 10 meter or anything, then the brick or the mass will store some energy. That is due to its position or elevation. That later on we will see, it will be calculated as mgh. So that much energy it is storing, which is called potential energy. Now we'll derive a mathematical expression of kinetic energy. To do so, suppose a vehicle is moving with a constant velocity capital V, and suddenly we are stopping its engine. That means what? We are discontinuing the supply of the energy to the vehicle, which was causing the motion. Now if I suddenly stop the engine, then also the vehicle will move some distance due to its inertia. Because at that time the only force acting on it is the frictional resistance, but its most the energy which it possessed due to its motion will have sufficient capacity to move it in the forward direction for a small time or for a small displacement. So that is the kinetic energy which is causing the motion after stopping the engine. So if we want to calculate the magnitude of that kinetic energy, we only have to check how much work done it is doing during this part. See, suppose initially the velocity of the car was capital V and suddenly we have stopped the engine. So the vehicle will start to retard, means the V will be gradually decreasing until it becomes zero. So at that time the acceleration will be in the opposite direction, means the vehicle will be in retardation. And the frictional resistance will try to stop it, so it will be acting in the opposite direction. It should not be written this way, A, it should be negative A. Isn't it? The magnitude, it should not be, we can show it. Means it want to mean that the vehicle is in retardation. So, suppose the vehicle displaces for S displacement, then it comes to rest. So, initial velocity is V and the final velocity is 0. So, by following the simple relation, V square equal to U square plus 2S, where final velocity is 0 and initial is V square. We don't know whether A is positive or negative. We just have put the values correspondingly. Finally, you have get that the A is minus V square by 2S, which is a negative term by following this relation. Now, if I apply the D'Alembert's principle on the moving vehicle, then what can I get? See, if I sum up the all forces acting on the moving vehicle, then it can be written either as the mass product acceleration, or by following the alternative method D'Alembert's principle, I can take all the forces at the same side and I can write the summation is zero. Here F means the frictional force which is resisting the motion, and Ma is the inertia force. As the acceleration is backward, means that it is in retardation, so the inertia force will be in the forward direction. See, as it is in retardation, so the inertia force will be in forward direction. Okay, and the friction is in the opposite direction. So we can write F minus Ma is equal to 0. This is the summation of all forces along the direction of motion. Finally, we get the frictional force is equal to Ma, means W by Ga, where M means the mass, which is the weight divided by gravitational acceleration. Now, if we want to know the kinetic energy in the body, then we have to calculate the work done by the forces on the body during its movement, during its S displacement. So, the work done by the frictional force F can be calculated by taking the product with the displacement, means F dot S. So, finally, we will get Fs cos 180 degree, as the angle between the force vector F and the displacement vector is 180 degree. So, finally, we will get minus Fs. Now, from our earlier calculation, we know that the total change in kinetic energy is equal to the work done on the body. So here the work done is W by G AS, isn't it? How do we get F is equal to W by G A? Because from the first relation, by applying D'Alembert's principle, we have got frictional force is same as the inertia force Ma. Okay, so here we get that the work done is W by G A, means Ma into S. Now, if I put back the value which we have got earlier, means if I replace the A by this term, minus V square by 2S, finally I will get half W by G V square is equal to half MV square. So, the mathematical expression of kinetic energy is this half MV square. Now, let me come to the potential energy. Potential energy depends on the position of the body. Due to the position, it possesses some energy that is called potential energy. And we know if we want to store any kind of energy in a body, then we must have to do some external work done on it. Suppose I am lifting a load, I am lifting a mass M to a height H by following some steps. So for the first step, how much work done I am doing? See, the displacement is upward H1 and the weight is acting Mg. So with respect to Mg, for the Mg, if I calculate the work done, I will get Mg dot H1. Here Mg, the angle between H1 and Mg is 180 degree, so there will be a negative term. So with respect to Mg, the Mg is doing some work, that is Mg H1 for this much height. Similarly, if I complete all the steps, finally we will attain a height H. So the total work done will be sum of mgh1 plus mgh2. This way, if I take mg common out, then it will be mg in bracket sum of the h1, h2, all the heights. The sum of the all heights are h. So finally, I will get mgh. It's the stored energy in the body, which is called potential energy. Next is power. Power is the time rate of doing work. Means here we are calculating how much work we are interacting per unit second. So the unit should be joule per second, which is called watt. Now work energy equation. See work energy equation for translation. Now we will find the work energy equation when the body is in pure translatory movement. Suppose there is a body whose shape is arbitrary and four unknown forces are acting on it, and due to which, as a result, the body is accelerating with a acceleration along the direction x. Now that we can conclude that sum of the all forces which are acting on the body must have the resultant along the x direction, because already we have seen that the body is moving in the x. So we can say the resultant of the all forces are acting in the x direction. Let us assume that resultant is R. Now from the Newton's second law, we know summation of all forces along the direction, summation of the all forces must be equal to the force mass times acceleration. So here the summation of all force, which have represented by capital R, is equal to mass times acceleration. Mass means W by G. Now multiplying both side by del S, suppose due to this application of force, the body has displaced S distance. Now we are considering our elementary displacement del S. So if I multiply the both side by del S, I will get R del S is equal to W by G A del S. Since we have a relation acceleration is equal to V del S, already it has been shown while we have derived the earlier relations, earlier basic equation like V square equal to E square plus 2 A del S. So now we can replace the A del S by V del V. After replacing the A del S by V del V, if you integrate the both side, the left side from 0 to S and the right side from the initial to the final velocity, we will get RS is equal to this. What is RS? RS is the work done on the body, and W by G V square minus E square by 2 is the change in kinetic energy on the body. So we can say the total work done on the body is equal to the change in kinetic energy of the body. Now let us take an example to make our concept much more clear. Suppose a body weighing 300 Newton is pushed up on a 30 degree plane by a 400 Newton force acting parallel to the plane. If the initial velocity of the body is 1.5 meter per second and coefficient of kinetic friction is mu is equal to 0.2, what will be the velocity after moving 6 meter? That means on an inclined plane, first there is a body whose weight is 300 Newton and the inclination of the plane is 30 degree. Now somebody is pushing the body in the uphill, in the upward direction by applying a force 400 Newton whose line of action is parallel to the inclined plane, and initial velocity of the body is 1.5 meter per second and the coefficient of friction between the two surfaces of the body and the inclined plane is 0.2. Now you have to calculate what will be the velocity of the body when it has passed 6 meter distance along the inclined plane. See, so this is our body. If we remove the inclined plane, then we can see the forces which are acting on it. One due to the ground reaction, means normal reaction, which will be perpendicular to it, N. And one is the frictional resistance, which will be tangential to it. And its magnitude is mu k n. And the weight always be vertically downward. If I split the weight into two parts, one will be acting in the negative x, 300 sine 30, and one will be acting at negative y, that is 300 cos 30, as the inclination is 30. And the applied force is 400 Newton, which is acting in the positive x, due to which, suppose it is causing a acceleration. So if we want to solve it by D'Alembert's principle, then we have to take the MA inertia force in the opposite direction. But we do not want to solve it by the D'Alembert's principle. We want to go for the work energy method. So this part is not required in this problem. just sum up the all forces along the x direction. 400 minus mu kn minus 300 sin 30 degree. As the body is accelerating in the x direction, so this summation is not equal to 0. Similarly, sum up the all forces in the y direction. By summing up the all forces in y direction, we can write the summation is 0, because in this direction the acceleration is 0. So finally, we want to calculate, already we have got a relation between the external work done on the body and on the change in kinetic energy. That is, the external work done on the body is equal to the change in kinetic energy. So if we can calculate the external work done on the body, then we can equate it to the change in kinetic energy. There we can get the final velocity as the initial is known. So the total work done on the body along the x direction, by the forces along the x direction, can be written as sum of the forces along x multiplied the displacement, which is mentioned in the problem, is 6 meter. So change in kinetic energy can be written this way, where the final velocity we have to know and the initial is 1.5 meter square. So if we equate these two, we will get velocity is equal to this.